SAR Learning Center. Here we are going to write an assembly language program to sort an array of data in ascending order. In this array can be stored in ascending order by bubble sorting. How we are going to sort a data in ascending order? In this concept, we are going to explain by using the bubble sorting method. In bubble sorting, the n data, that means we are going to take the 7 data. In this 7 data, we are going to perform n minus 1. That means 7 minus 1, that is a 6 comparison are performed by taking a 2 consecutive data at a time. After each comparison, the 2 data can be rearranged in the ascending order in the same memory location. After each comparison, the 2 data can be rearranged in the ascending order in the same memory location, that is smaller first and largest next. When the above n minus 1 comparison are performed, that means 6 comparison are performed 6 times, the array will be sorted in ascending order in the same locations. That is a problem analysis of the sorting of an array in ascending order. Now we are going to take one example. I will explain in step by step. First, what is our program? In the left hand side is our program. The first step of the program is move SI comma 1100H. What is the meaning? 1100H is a pointer. This is the SI register as a pointer for the array. These are the memory location 1100. This is the 07, 1101, AA, 77, FF, 22111, 44 and BB. 11012 1107, it is the data. This data can be sorted. How we are going to choose this data? Here we are mentioned 1100, we are mentioned the value of 07. In the 07 data, that is a 7 data can be taken here. If you are mentioned 08, means here we are going to take the data of 8 data. Okay, if you are mentioned 09, means we are taking the 9 data. Like that, we are going to perform. After that, we are going to compare. We are going to take the AA here. In this AA, we are going to compare with this next data. After that comparison, we are going to find which one is the smallest. Based on the smallest, the exchange can be take place. Now we are going to explain step by step by using this program. First, what is the first step? Move SI comma 1100H. It is the SI register as a pointer for the array. This is the first step. Now this 1100 is moved into the SI register. Here we are moving to the 1100. Next, what is the next step? In this step, move CL comma the square bracket of SI. What is the meaning? In this memory location is containing the value of 07. This 07 value is moved into the CL register. The CL register are used to perform in the number of time the comparison operation can be take place. First, we are move this SI value, that is 07 value, is moved into the CL register. What is the next step? Now we are going to decrement of the CL register. Now the decrement of the CL register, the CL register's value become 07 to 06. Okay, fine. This is a 06. What is the next step? What is the next step? Move SI comma 1100H. This is the initialize the pointer. In this pointer, now this value become 1100. That value, this memory location is containing the value of 07. The 07 value is moved into the CH register. The 07 value is moved into the CH register. What is the use of the CH register? This is the register is used to performing the comparison operation. This is the number of time we are going to compare. Here we are going to compare the comparison operation. That is a here simply it says this, it's a repetition, it's a recomparison. Repetition means how much time it can be compare. The comparison means we are going to compare one by one. This is a bubble sorting method. Okay, next, what is the next step? The next step, the decrement of CH. Why we are going to decrement of CL and CH? Already I told that Here we are going to take the n data. N data. N data means, for example, this AA. This AA we are going to compare first time, second time, third time, 4, 5, 6. This comparison operation can be take place by the n minus 1 time. That's why we are going to decrement of CH and CL register value. What is in the system? The next step is increment of the SI. In now the pointer value become 1100. Now increment of the SI value 1101. Okay. The value become 1101. Now the pointer value is located in this particular memory location. In this memory location is containing the value of AA. What is the next step? Now move AL comma SI. In this particular memory location is containing the value of AA. This AA value is moved into the AL register. Now it is moved into the AL register. What is the next step? The next step is increment of the SI. Now we are going to again increment of the SI. The SI register's value become 1102. This time this pointer is located in this memory location. In this memory location is containing the value of 77. Now we are going to compare. CMP means it's a compare. Compare AL comma the square bracket of SI. What is the SI value? The SI value become 1102. In this particular memory location is containing the value of 77. Now we are going to compare 77 with this AA. AA register is, the AL register value contain the value of AA. Now we are going to compare these two value. Which one is the smaller? What is the next step? The next step is jump carry. We are going to check the carry value. If AL is lesser than memory, okay, what is the meaning? If AL value become less, what is going to happen? This JC value is directly jump into the here decrement of the CH value. So no change can be take place because of this 1101 value is already available in the 1101 memory locations value is already available in AL. That's why no change will be occur because of we are going to perform the smallest value is first and largest value is next. That's why here is the smallest value. In this example, which one is the smallest one? The memory location value is the smallest one. Okay. What is the next step? That's why we are going to exchange the data. How we are going to exchange the data? By using the exchange command. XCHG AL, SI. What is the SI register value? SI memory location is containing the value of 1102. In this 1102, the memory location contains the value of 77. And AL register value contains the value of AA. Now we are going to exchange in between this two value. AA and 77. Now the 77 value is present here. Okay, what is our condition? The 77 value is move into the topmost of the memory location 1101. That's why again we are going to exchange the operation. In this exchange operation XCHG AL SI minus 1. What is the SI minus 1? SI value becomes 1102 minus 1 is 1101. That memory location is contain the value of AA. And AL registers contain the value of 77. Now we are going to exchange in between these two data. Now we are going to exchange this two data. Okay. Now this is the first step is completed. What is the next step? After completion of this step, we are going to decrement of the CH value. Why we are going to decrement? Next comparison we are going to take place. Now the value become decrement of CH. The CH value become 5. Okay. What is the next step? Next step, we are going to compare. AA value is compared with this FF. Okay. Look at here. JN is a recomparison. That means now I am, my program is moved into here. My program is moved into here. Okay. Next. Now move AL comma SI. Okay. What is the SI value? SI value become 1102. this SI value is moved into the particular memory locations containing the value of EIA. That value is moved into the EIL register. Next, we are moving increment of the SI. SI value becomes 1102. The pointer is located in this 1103. This memory location is containing the value of EFEF. Now we are going to compare AL, SI. What is the answer? Here this AL register's value becomes smaller compared with this memory location value. That's why we are here. There is no change in exchange. There is no change in exchange. Directly the decrement operation can be take place. No exchange can be take happen because of the AL register's value becomes smaller. Okay. That's why this value is jump into CH. Decrement of the CH. Okay. Like that we are going to perform. What is the next step? Again we are going to compare. Next, move SI value AL comma SI. Now the SI memory location, SI registers contain the value of 1103. This 1103 memory location contain the value of FF. Now this FF value is moved into the AL registers. Now this FF value is moved into the AL register. Next we are move increment of the SI. The SI value becomes 1104. The pointer is located in this 1104. In this memory locations contain the value of 02. This memory locations contain the value of 02. Now we are going to compare with AL with 22. This memory location FF 22. Here which one is the smallest? The 22 is the smallest. That's why we are going to exchange the operation. That's why we are going to exchange the data. Okay. Compare, we are going to compare. That time what is going to happen? The carry flag value becomes set. If the carry flag value becomes set, we are going to exchange the data. This data can be replaced in this memory location. That's why we are going to again exchange the AL comma SI minus 1. Okay, what is the next step? We are going to decrement of the CH. Now the decrement value becomes 0.3. What is the next step? Again, recomparison operation can be performed. Again, comparison. Now, the SI value becomes 1104. This 1104 memory location contains the value of FF. This FF value is moved into the AL. Okay, this value is moved into the AL. What is the next step? Increment of the SI. That value becomes 1105. Pointer is located in this 1105. This memory location is containing the value of 11. Okay. Next comparison of the AL comma SI memory locations value FF 11. Okay, here this is the 11. This is the FF. Here which one is the smallest? The memory location is the smallest. That's why we are going to check the carry flag value. The carry flag value becomes set. That's why we are going to exchange the data from AL to memory. Again the exchange operation can be take place from the SI minus 1. Here this is the 11. This FF is moving to here. What is the next step? Again decrement of the CH value. The CH value becomes 2. Okay. This comparison operation can be performed until the CH value becomes 00. Okay. Now JN is Z. That is the meaning of jump not equal to 0. That means the CH register's value is not equal to 0 until that comparison operation can be performed. Okay. Now the next comparison, move AL comma SI. SI value is moving to AL. Again increment of SI. Now the pointer is located in this 1106. The data is 44. Now we are going to compare. Now the 44 is smaller. That's why we are going to check the carry flag. The carry flag value becomes set. That's why we are going to exchange the data in between the 1106 to AL. Now the AL data is moving to the 1105. Okay. Next, we are going to decrement of the CH registers. The CH registers value becomes 01. Now again, comparison operation can be performed. Now this value becomes moving to the AL. Again, increment of SI. SI value becomes 1107. The pointer is located in this 1107. That time the 1107 memory location contained the value of BB. Okay, this now the carry flag value becomes set. That's why we are move the sorry, exchange the data from 1107 to AL. Okay, like that we are going to perform. Now 1106 memory location containing the value of BB. Then containing the value of BB. Look at here, this is the BB. Now look at here, this is not an ascending order, because here we are going to perform decrement of the CHN. Before that, I'm going to explain. Now the CH registers value becomes 00. Now the CH registers value become 00. Okay. Now we are going to check J and Z recomparison. Now that register value, that the CH registers value becomes 0. That's why we are move into the next step. What is the next step? The next step is decrement of the CL register. Why we are going to decrement of the CL register? Okay, this is not an ascending order. Once again, I am going to recompare this one. How much time we are going to repetition of this operation? Okay, we are going to take the 7 data, 6 comparison operation already performed. Once again, we are going to repeat this operation. The 6 comparison also can be take place. That's why this decrement of the CL. The first cycle is completed. Next, we are going to perform the second cycle. That's why decrement of the CL. Now the CL value become 0.5. Now we are going to check the CL registers value. The CL registers value is not equal to 0. Okay. Again, we are moving into the repeat step. Here, come to here. Now the SI value is moved into the CH. That time that value becomes 0.7. Now decrement of the CH. Again, we are going to perform the again comparison. The 77 is compared with AA. Now the 77 is in this memory location. Again, AA is compared with this 1103. This is the smallest number. That's why this data is come here and AA here. Next, we are going to compare this 1111. Again, 11 come to here and AA is here. Next, we are going to compare here. Compare with this 44 come to here and AA is here. Like that, we are going to perform the comparison operation until the CL registers value becomes 0. Once the CL registers value becomes 0, we are getting the ascending order. We are getting the ascending order. Okay. Like that, we are going to perform. Okay. Like that, we are going to perform. Now, this is the final step. In this final step, the CH registers value becomes 0 and CL registers value becomes 0. In this time, the number can be arranged in ascending order. The number can be arranged in ascending order. This is our program. Now, we are going to execute this program by using this 8086 emulator. Okay, this is our emulator. Okay, this is the 8086 emulator. In this 8086 emulator, our program is move SI, 1100 gauge. This is the SI register as a pointer for the array. Here, move CL, SI, square bracket of SI, the CL as a count for n minus 1 repetition. Already I told why we are going to repetition this operation. Okay, until we are going to arrange the ascending order. Decrement of the CL, why we are going to decrement of the CL? If you are taking the 7 data, the 6 comparison operation can be performed. As like that, we are going to perform the 6 repetition can be take place. Next, move SI 1100 H. Move CH value become SI. This is the comparison, n minus 1 comparison, decrement of CH. Again, we are going to increment of the SI. Move AL, SI. Get the element of array in AL register. The first data is moved into the AL register. Next, we are going to move increment of the SI. Next, we are going to compare this AL with this memory location. Okay. Next, we are going to check which one is the largest and which one is the smallest. If AL is smallest, that is a no change. That is a no change. That is a no change means if your AL becomes less. If AL becomes less, what is going to happen? This program is move jump into decrement of the CH. Next comparison operation can be perform. If AL value becomes larger, the memory location value, that is the SI memory location pointer, okay, the pointer is located in particular memory location. In this memory location containing this particular value, that value becomes less, we are going to exchange the AL comma SI. After that, we are move this AL register, smallest value is move into the SI minus 1. Okay, like that we are going to perform this operation. This is a JN, is a, that is a jump not 0, not equal to 0. Here we are going to check the CH register value. CH register value is not equal to 0. Again, the recomparison operation can be started from here. If the CH register value becomes 0, what is going to happen? Again, decrement of the CL. Okay, if the decrement of the CL, again check the CL register value. If the CL register value is not equal to 0, again this repetition operation can be performed. Like that, we are going to compare with this number. This concept is called as the bubble sorting concept. After execution of this program, what is going to happen? We are going to take the number as in this ascending order. I am going to execute this program, emulate. After this emulation, there is no error. I am going to load our data in this particular memory. My memory address is 1100. Okay, in this 1100 memory location, our example, okay, 07, we are going to take the 7 data. Next, first data is AA, the second data is 77, next data is FF, the next data is 22, next data is 11. What is the next data? That is a 44, next data is BB. That is the 7 data we are going to take, we are going to update. Now we are going to execute, if you are using single step, move, 1100 value is moving into the particular memory location SI register. After that, SI register value is moving into this CL. Then we are move decrement of the CL. Again, this SI register value is moving into the CH, that value becomes 07, decrement of 07, value into C06, increment of the SI. We are going to take the first data into the AL register. The first data is AA. Okay, first data is present in this 1101 memory location. This data is moving into the AL registers. Again, we are going to increment of the SI register. Now 1102, this is the value of 77. Now we are going to check the comparison of the AL comma SI. Here, which one is the smallest? The memory location value is the smallest. We are going to check with this flags. Okay, flags. Okay, next step. This is the carry flag value. Carry flag value is not set because of the memory location value becomes zero. Sorry, memory location value becomes less. That's why we are going to exchange the operation. Like that, we are going to perform until CH and CL registers value become 0. CH and CL registers value become 0. Once the CL and CH registers value become 0, what is going to happen after execution of this program? After execution of this program, what is going to happen? Look at here. Wait until, okay, now the program is halted. Now the CH registers value becomes 00 and CL registers value becomes 00. What is our result? Our result can be 11, 22, 44, 77, AA, BB, FF. This is the program to arrange our data in ascending order. Thank you.